Okay, welcome back to my new root tutorial. First of all, I'm sorry that I was not able to upload any video for a long time. But in one of the previous videos, I was asked to make a short introduction into the class tcut. So this will come now. Basically, tcut can be used to analyze the data in a tree much faster than writing your own analysis script. Of course, in some cases you need a little bit deeper analysis, so you have to write a script. But with the help of tcut, you can do some easy analysis very quick. So, in order to do this, in order to show how it works, we will first create, as we are always doing, a new file. In this case, let's call it 220.c. And the first thing which we are doing is to write our main function, which is in this case void toot20. And instead of writing everything which we are doing now into this main function, I want to show you how to separate this in different functions. So let's suppose we want to first write a tree and then read it out. So we can create two functions. Let's suppose let's call it write and read, and these two functions we have to define now above that. So first we define the function write, and in this the first thing which we do if we want to create a tree is to create a file. So we use again tfile, and let's call it output, new tfile. And the file name should be, in order to be consistent, 220.root, and we have to recreate it. Okay, then we have to define the tree. So ttree, like always, new ttree. And just give the name tree to make it easy. And then we define two variables that we want to store in the tree. So in this case, also simply x and y. And then, as I have explained in one of the last videos, we can create two branches for each variable one. And this we will also just call x. And it should be a double, so we have to write it in this way. And then the next branch, of course, will be y. And also here, it will be a double. Now we can fill this with various data, but in order to show what tcut is doing, I think the best idea would be to to plot x, or to store values of x that are just random values, and y could be then something proportional to x. So just create again, as we are always doing, random variable r, and again we use the trandom2 generator, which is I think more stable for int, and we create a large amount, I guess, smaller, let's suppose 1 million, and in this case we don't want to just create it between 0 and 1. Of course, we can also do this, but to make it a little bit more nicer, we can create random variables between 1 and 10. This is just arbitrary. Of course, as I said, we can also use any other value, but maybe it's nicer to see at the end. And then let's suppose we want to say that the variable y should be connected with x by just multiplying with 2. So it is directly proportional to x. And then, of course, during every step, we have to fill the tree with the numbers that we created. And at the end, when everything is finished, the for loop has passed, then we can write the output file. And also, of course, in this case, it's very essential. It's not an ASCII file, it's a root file, so we have to make sure that we really close it at the end. Okay, and then we can save this. First, for the time being, we will comment this function read out, so we can test it already with this function. So let's put it in the background. Started with 220.c. It ran without any problems. And now we should be able to see the root file, 220.root. And again, we create a new tbrowser. And I will make it a little bit larger. I hope it's possible to read it. Yeah, so here we see the x values in between 1 and 10 as we have created it. And now we do the same for the y values. And if we open it, we see here values in between 2 and 20. So just x multiplied by 10 for every single value that we have created. Okay, this seemed to work well. And now we have to read out the tree. So we can do it either with, as I have explained it one time, with this branch addresses and so on. But in order to show what tcut can do, we will do it a little bit differently. So maybe we will just, we will not call it read. Maybe we can just call the function cut to show what it does. Okay, so in any case, first we have to read the file out. And we so as an we use it as an input file basically, so tfile, and we called it 220.root, and in this case we don't need to, we can write it that we want to read out the file, but of course if we not write anything it automatically sets the flag to read, and then we have to tell root which tree we want. And this we can do in this way, input get tree. I hope you are still familiar with this writing style. If not, then maybe you can take a look at the previous video which I made about how to store and read trees. And we can now basically draw the the y values just by simply writing t draw y. This is the easiest way how to read out the tree. Instead of writing, this, as I said, this branch addresses and so on, so we can use just this command. And I try to run it, but it does not work because I think I just forgot here the equal sign. No? So now run it. And we can see here all y values are presented in this nice automatically created histogram with the right number amount of values and so on. So 1 million is shown here. Mean value is okay. Standard deviation is also okay. And now just we define a cut. So let's call it cut one. Of course, we can also just call it only cut, but maybe we want to create more conditions in the future. So it would be a nice idea to also number it. So let's suppose we call it cut one. And the condition would be that we only want to show the y numbers where the x numbers are smaller than 5, just randomly chosen as a condition. Now we can run it. And we see of course, this will not work because we have to define or we have to insert the condition here in drawing the tree, the x value, the y values of the tree. And now this was the wrong file, 220.c we have to run. And now if everything works well, we see here all values in between 2 and 10. And also the number of entries has been reduced. So of course it can only shows values in between 2 and 10 just because we multiply the x values with 2. And if we cut all x values above 5, then we can only see all the y values in between 2 and 10. Okay, so now I want to show you how to create another cut and combine it with that. So let's call it tcut 2, and we want to show only y values where x is larger than 5 and smaller than 6. So we can do this in the following way. And now we have to make an AND connection between cut 1 and cut 2. So we can simply write cut 1 and cut 2. Double AND. And when we run it, we should be able to see, I think at the moment the laptop is really slow. We should be able to see only values in between 2 times 5, which is 10, and 2 times 6, which is 12. So exactly what we predict. And the number of entries has been reduced by a factor of 10 approximately. Also exactly what we expect. In the same way, we can also make some OR connection. So let's suppose we want to show only values which are larger than 5 and smaller than 5 and larger than 6. So of course, this will not make any sense at the moment. But if you write an OR connection, which is 2 times these vertical lines, and we run it, then you can see here, you basically make a cut in between 10 and 12 for the Y values, and all other values are shown perfectly. And this you can do for all your branches, for all variables. You can make cuts whatever you like. You can insert as many cuts as you want. Of course, if the analysis gets too complicated, I always prefer to write a real analysis script, which makes this, which includes all the steps for your analysis, maybe in separate functions and so on. But for just making a very coarse analysis and to get an idea about what data is stored in your tree, these cuts are somehow nice. Maybe you can play a little bit around with this. Try to make your own code, try to apply it on your own analysis. If you have any questions, maybe you can write it in your comments. If you have not done so far, please subscribe my channel. I hope this video helped you a little bit to understand Root better, and see you next time.